Kenny, I have an idea. For the rest of this month, we should bring the kids in and Jungle Terry. I think
and
we should.
Candy.
Yeah, and candy.
Well, definitely.
I think that would be a ratings bonanza, I think, you know?
I think so. I like
this
it.
This time, release the snakes and the mice at the same time. Set it separately.
As long as you guys are on one side of the studio and they're on the other.
Like, right. Like in the bathroom down the hall.
Right. And begin. Close the door. Okay, well, we're at the Cleveland Museum of Art, literally one of the best museums in the United States of America. And they're really excited here, as well as all of us should be, because they had the biggest gift that's been given in the past 60 years, Heather, and that's quite amazing. About 100 pieces of extraordinary art. Well, you know, when we're starting with a couple of Picassos over our shoulder, it's gonna be a good day, right?
Exactly.
All right, and so these are a few Picassos from the collection we see here, right?
Right. Mm-hmm. This one came from Joe and Nancy Keithley's collection. It was made in the 1920s. It's from the Surrealist period.
And the one Lamont's looking at right now.
And we've coupled that with one of the paintings from our own collection, and that came in 1958 with the Leonard C. Hanna bequest. It's from his Rose period, so 20 years before, and you see the incredible difference in style. He was so versatile.
Isn't that amazing?
Isn't it?
And this is significant because there's a great history of philanthropy and donors over the history of the museum. But this is really cool because you get to see how much people get to share the art that's made them and brought them so much joy.
Exactly. The Keithleys collected these works of art in dialogue with the museum for over 20 years. But every single work of art that you see in this exhibition was something that they selected and loved.
Gotcha.
And they wanted to buy at a level of museum quality, hoping that one day the collection would come here, and we certainly hoped it would.
Well, some people are enjoying breakfast here, which kind of ties it. We're going to start with this one. This is a really cool scene over here. Lamont, right here. Okay, talk to us about this one, Heather.
This is by Pierre Bonnard. He was a French artist working in the late 19th and early 20th century.
Yeah.
And here we see a dining table where perhaps many of our listeners are sitting right now. The table is laid with fruit in blue and white porcelain dishes, not unlike
over here
the Chinese and Japanese porcelains that are in this case. The Keithleys also collected Asian porcelains, and throughout the exhibition, we've woven those porcelains and ceramics and stoneware vessels into the exhibition in what we hope are interesting conversations with the paintings.
And then you guys paired this picture, again another scene by Pierre.
Exactly. This is another dining scene, also by Pierre Bonnard, a French artist. And this one was in our collection, and it shows two figures, his wife and a family friend, at a dining table after a meal. His wife seems to be gazing out the window.
And the dog is getting a treat here, it looks
the
like.
The dog is waiting for a treat. Exactly. And just like in the Keithley's dining table, we have no figures in this one.
A dog and a cat there.
Exactly.
See,
the family pets.
Art is so interesting. Even Kenny can find a dog and a cat. There you go. All right, when we come back, so much more to show you guys. This is so cool. One of the best museums in the land, and it's right here in Cleveland. All right, back to you guys in the studio.